All right, welcome back everyone to yet another daily video here. And in today's video, I wanted to cover a new metric for Robinhood that I've not seen anyone else post. So to my understanding, I'm the only one that took the time and effort to do this. And let me tell you, I understand why no one else has done it. But if we jump over to the Excel here, we can see that Robinhood has been doing pretty well. The last 90 days, if we look at the chart, it's been up and to the right from $40 to $110, which is a new all-time high as of the closing yesterday. But what I wanted to talk about today is a completely new Robinhood chart that details Robinhood's market share of the overall crypto market. So you know that historically I've done this equities market share chart, where we take overall Robinhood equities volumes, and then we map it against the US notional trading volumes, and then we can get market share. So Robinhood, of course, during the 2021 craze, did a lot of the overall trades in the US equities markets, but since then kind of dropped off, and has since then started to have a resurgence here in 2024. If we look at the annual chart, it is a bit of a not quite a V-shaped recovery, but we are returning back to those overall 2021 levels, closing at 0.77% of US equities notional volume in 2024. But that is equities. And as we know with Robinhood, equities don't really make a lot of the revenue, because the yield on equities, let me see here, equities yield is actually very, very low. So 0.01% of the dollar based volumes actually becomes revenue. That is not very exciting. And as you can see, it is going down and into the right, as the US equities market are very mature. There are not a lot of spread opportunities for the market makers to pay up for. Instead, what Robinhood does make a lot of revenue on is cryptocurrencies. If we see here, we have an opposite kind of chart. Instead of declining since 2021, it is actually going up. So 0.52% crypto yield, or take rate if you want, in 2025 Q1. Compare that to the equities yield, which is 0.01. So you have to do 52 times the equities volume just to equal the crypto volume. So yeah, it is very, very profitable, and there's a lot of revenue to be had from cryptocurrencies for Robinhood. But what we're covering here is the actual market share. So as we can see here, market share reached 1% in Q4 of 2024, and then declined slightly in Q1. But the point here is that there's a lot of market share to be had for Robinhood. I mean, when people talk about, I missed out on Robinhood, because when you look at this chart, you see a new all-time high, so you're like, I'm too late to Robinhood. I'm telling you, we are very early in the Robinhood story. This is just getting started. But the chart I want to talk about is cryptocurrencies market share. Now, of course, similarly to equities, the crypto market share was really, really high in 2021, and it has since been on the decline. A bit of a resurgence here, but still, I mean, a majority of the crypto trading is done far away from Robinhood, which means that Robinhood has a big opportunity ahead of itself to take and gain market share over time. I mean, we're only at 0.66% of in 2025. However, on the annual chart, like when you even out the periods, like doing on the 4-quarter basis, we can actually see that it has been going up ever since 2022, when it was 0.41, so a slight increase, and now we're 0.63, which shows, you know, quite a big increase in overall market share. So I will be tracking this, but an important note here, what I want to talk about, if you don't care about how this is calculated, then you can you know, close the video, but make sure to like and subscribe before you do. But I want to talk about this. I write here approximated. And the reason for that is we do not have the exact trading volume composition in order to know the exact market share. So the way I have done this, it is the most accurate way that I could think of. So if we go over to the Excel sheet here, which by the way is available on typefcapital.com, so you can go and grab this Excel sheet. If we look here in the trading metrics here that I have, Robinhood does report trading volumes for equities in billions, and also cryptocurrencies in dollar billions. So here we have a reference point. But the problem is we don't know what cryptocurrencies are included here, because, you know, there are thousands and thousands of coins. Not all of them trade on Robinhood, and not all of them trade, even those that do trade on Robinhood, they haven't been available since 2021. I mean, Robinhood keeps adding new coins, perhaps even removes some coins over time. So we don't really know exactly, like, okay, how much of this 46 billion in Q1 was BTC? How much of that was Ethereum? We don't really know that, which makes it very difficult to approximate it against the actual overall cryptocurrency volume. So what I've done here is I've gone to CoinMarketCap. I made a post on X where I was like, okay, for people who like crypto, can you point me to a credible source of volume data? And most people said, yeah, probably CoinMarketCap is the best one. So I went to CoinMarketCap, and what I've done is I went to, for example, BTC here. And this was a painful process and it took a lot of time. But I went to TradingView here. We can accept cookies. I did it on a monthly basis. And then I manually went back, starting from 2021. I look at the volume here. So in the top left here, you can see that volumes for January were $2.153 trillion. Q2 was $2.267 trillion. And this is still Q1. So January, February, and March. March was $1.681 trillion. So then I combine those three, and then I have, if we go back to Excel, then I have a Q1 here of 2021. And then I did that all throughout, all the way into Q2 of 2025. So it is a painful process. It took a lot of time. But if you look here, I only have three different cryptos. So I have Bitcoin, Ethereum, and Dogecoin. And why is that? Well, it is the best guess I can do based on data of what is actually being traded on Robinhood. Now, there is no guarantee that a majority of the trading here is one of these three. It could be a very, very small coin that is available, but I can't make that guess. So what I base this on is, if we go a little bit further down here, Robinhood used to report safeguarded user cryptocurrency. So basically, what are people holding on the platform? Now, this is holding. This is not what they are trading. So it could be that people buy and hold Bitcoin and never trade it. But, you know, it is still the best guess I can do. So if we look at the percentages, this started in Q2 of 2022. So during that quarter, 33% of overall safeguarded cryptocurrencies was Dogecoin. Now, that is kind of surprising to me, because it is the largest holding people had on Robinhood, like higher than Bitcoin at 32%, higher than Ethereum at 25%. So those three combined accounted for 90% of all safeguarded cryptos, because the fourth category here is other. So that other could be any other coin. We have no idea. But consistently, these three make up a majority, because if we look here on the other category, 10%, 13, 11, 11, 11, 10, 10, 11, 10, 10. and they stopped reporting this suddenly in Q3 of 2024. So we don't know the next two quarters here, but consistently other as a category in terms of being safeguarded is approximately 10%. And these three make up the majority of what people are holding on the platform. Now, I say that they are holding it. So we don't actually know if people are really trading this a lot or not, but it is still the best guess that we can do given the information we have as to what we should compose our, you know, cryptocurrency volumes based on. So they account for approximately 90% of all safeguarded cryptos during the reportable period. So that's, those are the three I used to actually compile the volume data to compare the trading volumes against. And then when you divide that, you get a market share. So similarly to how I do the market share for US equities notional volume, I compile the trading days and then average daily US equity consolidated volumes, both in shares, but also in the notional volume, which is in billions. And then that's what I use to get a market share against the, you know, equity trading volume for the quarter. So, you know, it is a lot of math and you really need credible sources to do this properly. So the only one that I'm really confident in is the equities one. For crypto, it is just an approximated market share based on the information we have available. Hopefully, I mean, it is a lot of work for Robinhood to break this, you know, to break it out so we can actually see the, you know, real market share. But this is the approach I did based on the data we have available. If you have a better way to do this, you know, please let me know in the comments. But this is the way that I could think of doing it, given the information we have available. So yeah, that is it for today's video. I thought it's interesting. And if you're a Robinhood shareholder, you might find this interesting. I don't think anyone else has posted this before. So with that said, thank you so much for watching today. I'll be doing one video per day throughout the whole of July. So please like and subscribe if you have not already. And you can find my Substack over at research.typeofcapital.com. Yesterday, I posted this huge Palantir equity research article. So it is available for free. Please go check it out. It is very long. Tells you everything you need to know about Palantir. And with that said, thank you so much, everyone, for watching. And I will see you guys tomorrow. Bye-bye.